I'm Rach. Guys, thank you so much for coming out here. I'm so excited. You guys were blowing up Twitter, which is super cool because Tove Lo is back there and she's so excited to meet you guys. You guys are pretty devoted fans. And then everyone's like, oh my God, I don't know if I'm ready for this. Get ready because she is amazing. She has a new album coming out this fall. I'm sure you're all aware. And we got to chatting a little bit and we'll talk more here together so we can enjoy it. But once you find out why this album is going to be called the way it is, you're going to die. But anywho, I'm going to stop talking and let her come out here. Tove Lo, give her a round of applause. There she is. Come on up. Thank you. I started laughing by myself thinking about our conversation before. And then I realized I might as well just like bring you out here and chat with you. Oh, I have two microphones. Okay, sorry, I hijacked the other one. So wait, let me get my sheet of paper because you have like a lot of things going on for you in life right now. Of course, you are so renowned for the amazing songs you have out. Habits got you to, I believe, number one on the top 40 charts.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh my gosh. Grammy nominated, Billboard Music Awards nominated. Tell us a little bit about that journey going into, I guess, the music industry for you.
Well, where do you want me to start?
I know. Okay, so inspo for music came from where?
Well, I've always kind of just written about my life mm-hmm. and what's
what
been
age?
Going on. I was always writing kind of like journals and poems and stuff, but didn't like actually start writing songs until I was maybe like 18, 19 or something.
Dear diary.
fully. I have my journal since I was like 9 years old.
Wow, that's amazing.
Crazy, yeah.
Cool. And then your first experience on stage kind of happened around when for you?
I went to this music high school in Sweden that it's a public school and you just basically audition and you get in based on your grades and your audition. And my parents let me apply because they were like, she'll never get in. She's not. Because I wasn't a very good singer, like until I like went to the high school and started practicing and stuff. So, but I got in. And when I was there, it was kind of like when I started, you know, dreaming about it for real. Because it was kind of like, oh, this is an opportunity for me now, you know?
Right.
And so, yeah, I think I just, first time I performed on stage was at that school, like kind of for a little, you know, in a cafeteria during lunch, you do these little concerts, and like I was dying my nerves. I was so nervous.
So you guys have like talent shows at lunch every day?
Yeah,
that's a fun high school.
Yeah, it was cool. It was cool.
So cool.
It was actually a really good experience. A lot of pressure, but it was really good for me.
Yeah,
yeah.
And you've kind of established yourself as an individual artist, but you've also worked with a bunch of artists as well, and you've written a song for Ellie Goulding.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so tell us a little bit about that, and if you could work with one other person, who was your favorite person to work with?
I've had a few with Ellie. It was like, I was a small part of Love Me Like You Do. Mm-hmm. I just helped out a little bit with the lyrics there. But then I also co-wrote another one song with her. She's really cool. She's a great writer. So it was a very like chill experience. And you never know, like as a writer, when I go into a session with an artist, it's like, I know the artist, you're just, you know, you're there in a different role. So it's always like if you haven't met them yet, you have no idea what they're like.
Right.
And you're just like, is this going to be chill? Or are you just batshit crazy? I don't know. but literally haven't had like a session where that's been like, you know, a thing. So
good.
I loved working with her. And I also loved writing with Lord. That was an amazing experience. Mm-hmm. I've been writing a bit with Dua and that was also really, really fun.
I feel like in a weird way, you have your own style, but in a weird way, you kind of like resonate in styles with those artists, but they're also all very different. So I feel like you kind of are eclectic in that sense and where you embody all of these different
bad pop bitches.
Yeah, there you go. So we were talking a little bit about your album that's coming out in the mm-hmm. fall. Mm-hmm. It's called, I can't even do this, Sunshine Kitty. Mm-hmm. I've already teased everyone and like kind of told them that's hilarious why it's called that name. So I guess we can do like a PG-13 rated version of.
let me try and do that.
I mean, we're all open and honest here.
The inspiration comes from kind of just it being a bit more like hopeful, kind of happier album. And then also like just a new play on Pussy Power. That. Can I say that?
Yeah, whatever. At this point, you just go for it.
And it's also inspired by this girls episode where...
love that show.
Let me see how I can explain this without being honestly, too graphic.
We're all friends here. Go for it.
Where she talks about this author who... You know, everyone talks about the glow on her face, and she says that, like, well, it's not makeup or anything. It's because she sits out and, like, tans her vagina and soaks up the power of the sun, and that's where she gets her glow. And I just thought that was really funny and hilarious, and that's, yeah,
Sunshine
part
Kitty.
Of the inspiration. Yeah.
Get it? Okay. Now, you have a new single off that album that you gave us a little sneak peek with. You dropped that, and it's available now. Mm-hmm. Are we going to hear that today?
Yes, you are.
Okay. Yeah. So let's get to it. I'll stop talking so you can start singing. Let's bring your amazing guitarist up here.
You won.
And let's get to it. What song are we listening to first, girlfriend?
I want to start with, you know... the song and the breakup that changed my whole life in, like, overnight.
The whole situation.
Yeah. The whole situation. Yes. The, like, breakup you're thankful for and all that. Is it unhappy?
Yeah. A little bit. Are you okay?
Yeah.
All right.
All right, let's do it.
I eat my dinner in my bathtub, then I go to sex clubs, watching freaky people getting it on. It doesn't make me nervous, if anything I'm restless. Yeah, I've been around and I've seen it all. I get home, I got the munchies, binge on all my Twinkies, throw up in the tub, then I go to sleep. And I drank up all my money, tasting kinda lonely. You're gone and I gotta stay high all the time to keep you off my mind. Ooh, ooh, high all the time to keep you off my mind. Ooh, ooh, spend my days locked in a haze, trying to forget you, babe. I fall back down. I gotta stay high all my life to forget I'm missing you. Daddy's at the playground, how I spend my daytime, losing up the frown, make them feel alive. I'll make it fast and greasy, I'm number way too easy. You're gone and I gotta stay high all the time to keep you off my mind. Where the fun ain't got no end. No, I can't go home alone again. Need someone to numb the pain. No, staying in my play pretend. Where the fun ain't got no end. No, can't go home alone again. Need someone to numb the pain.
That's a mood. Okay. Okay, amazing. So we all know and love that one, right? Mm-hmm. Yep. Now we wanna. Sorry, I'm totally up in your dance space.
Hey, come on in.
Oh,
come
you know, I'd break it down up here, but I don't want to scare you guys. So we're gonna get a glimpse of your new album with your new song.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about it.
Glad He's Gone. It's I would say the pep talk that I've given my friends so many times and been given a lot of times when you're dating someone that just isn't good for you and it's over and you're heartbroken, but you still have to just celebrate it because you're actually better off without him.
So she's the friend we all need. Raise your hand if you agree. Yes, we all agree. Go ahead, girlfriend. Break it down. Let's hear it.
Got a girlfriend, she's got a boyfriend. She calls me crying every day cause they got problems. He lies complaining, she's compromising. Coming to me for real advice when he just playing. I can tell she loves him way too deep. He loves being super hard to please. Cover the basics, it's pretty easy. He's a douche with some expectations. Did you get down on his birthday? Did you let him do the things he likes?
Yeah.
Or did you show him all you're crazy?
No.
Blow him up on the wing. Did you give it to his ego? Just to give a little confidence. I think you know it's time to let go. I'm glad that he's gone, my baby. Never no tears for that sucker. Only one love, that's a bummer. Dancing all night, get guys' numbers. I'm glad that he's gone. No tears for that sucker. But never go dry this whole summer. Wanna get over, get under. I'm glad that he's gone, he's gone, he's gone. You're better off. I'm glad that he's gone, he's gone, he's gone. You're better off. I'm glad that he's gone. Girl, I love you. He never loved you. He never saw the pretty things in you that I do. I missed your madness. You kinda ratchet. We used to go out every night, get into bad things. You and me under each other's wing. We were free till he spoiled everything. Cover the basics, it's pretty easy. He's a douche with some expectations. Did you get down on his birthday?
Yep.
Did you let him do the things he likes?
Yep.
Did you show him all you're crazy?
No.
Blow him up on the weekends. Did you give in to his ego? Just to give a little confidence. I think you know it's time to let go. I'm glad that he's gone, my baby. Never no tears for that sucker. Only one love, that's a bummer. Dancing all night, get guys numbers. I'm glad that he's gone. Baby, no tears for that sucker. But never go dry this whole summer. Wanna get over, get under. He's gone, he's gone, he's gone. You're better off. I'm glad that he's gone, he's gone, he's gone. You're better off. I'm glad that he's gone. You and me under each other's wing. But he spoiled everything. Girl, I love you. He never loved you. Never loved you, my baby. Never no tears for that sucker. Only one love, that's a bummer. Dancing all night, get guys' numbers. I'm glad that he's gone. Baby, no tears for that sucker. But never go dry this whole summer. Wanna get over, get under. I'm glad that he's gone, he's gone, he's gone. You're better off. I'm glad that he's gone, he's gone, he's gone. You're better off. I'm glad that he's gone. Thank you.
Give it up for Johan.
Wait, I'm so obsessed. Wow, I'm not even fangirling right now. Maybe I am, but it's fine. Is it cool if we play a little game?
Sure.
I think we have time, right?
You guys can play games.
Game? Okay, we're playing games. First off, we have to acknowledge your shoes. Those are dope.
Thank you.
Yes. Okay, so if you guys are taking socials on your phones. Are you guys taking socials on your phones? No, this is a good thing. If you are, this is great. Just make sure you tag us at Q102 Philly, okay? All right. And of course, me and Tove. All right. So this game I like to call, and if you guys have any in your brains as we play along, keep them, and then we'll raise your hand and take a few of yours afterwards. It's called Tove Lo. Get it? Lo. So we're going to give you a mix of artists, TV shows, movies, foods, and you have to rank them high or low on your list of things that you prefer.
Sounds good.
Easy?
Okay.
Okay. Billie Eilish.
Hi.
Hi. She like a huge inspo for you?
Yeah, just, yeah, I think she's great.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's
and
amazing.
These things that I'm about to list off are like very hyped up things. Like,
cool.
They're definitely in right now, but like it could go either way for a lot of people. So I'm glad that we love Billie. So this is good. All right. Game of Thrones.
Hi. I mean, low because it's done.
Yeah, that's definitely low. Pretty bummer.
Bummer. Yeah.
Okay. I actually never watched that show, so no one hate me. I need to get into it. I know.
You know, I didn't watch it for the first six seasons. And then my friend sat me down and he was like, okay, you need to watch this show. Like, if you don't watch this, we can't be friends anymore.
Right.
And so I literally spent, I was staying at his place and I left the 4th of July party to go home and watch it. Cause I was like so in it. I started watching it like at night when I couldn't sleep. And I was like, in 2 weeks, I'd watch the six seasons. But I literally was at a party and was like, guys, I'm not feeling well. I'm going to go. And I went home and just like watched like four episodes or something.
Okay, that's the tea. Yeah. That's why Tove Lo was not at her 4th of July party.
So you should still get into it.
Okay, yeah. Honestly, that's the scariest part is knowing how much I have to catch up with. So I guess I'll just rip the Band-Aid off. Okay, Zac Efron.
Hi. Yeah. I was impressed by his when he played, you know, Ted Bundy, I think it was, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
I was like, I didn't know he could do murder. Good. Yeah.
I'm not going to lie. I was really tired and I fell asleep during the movie, but he still looked good. It's fine. The Lion King. Have you seen it?
I have. I saw it just a couple of days ago and I cried so much, even though you know what happens. They're just so cute. The cubs are just so fluffy and yeah.
Okay. So it's a high?
It's a high.
Okay, good.
I like everything.
I was just going to say, you're very easy to please. All right. So you're from Sweden.
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel about Swedish fish?
Very low. Ew.
Maybe not all things.
It's just not the, I'm like, it's not the candy. No, you mean the candy, right?
Yes.
Not actual fish.
No.
Yeah, no.
I don't think
no,
I
don't
that.
Like the Swedish fish. No.
Okay, then what about Swedish meatballs?
I'm vegetarian, so that's a low.
So it's a low. Yeah. Okay. All right. Now we know. Now we know. Do any of you guys have any in your minds? Because that's all I got. Yeah. Come up here. Or I'll come to you.
Marina.
Oh, hi. Yeah, love her.
Wait, fill me in.
Marina Diamonds.
Okay, I swear I'm educated. What is this?
She's an artist. She's an amazing artist. Yeah.
I work in radio. I swear. Anybody else? All right, well, that was a good one, I guess. Sorry, I suck, guys. Okay, well, that's our game of Tove Lo. Round of applause. Any questions for Tove before she heads out? Yes?
They're from this brand called 80s, like EYTYS. They have a bunch of really cool shoes. They're heavy, but they're still comfortable. Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Okay, love. I know you got something pending up there. Or not, that's fine too.
So what song are you most excited for us to hear off the new album?
Ooh, I think probably... Well, I have one, the next song coming out quite soon, which is like the next, Sweet Talk of My Heart is the next single that I'm really excited for you guys to hear. You might have heard already because I posted a little sneak peek on my, but Baddest of Boys is another song that I'm doing with this other female artist who's awesome that I hope you guys will like.
This other female artist? Is it Marina Diamond?
No, it's not, unfortunately, but.
Darn. I would finally get with it. Anybody else? Yes.
How would you say this album, the sound, differs from your previous?
I would say it's a bit like happier in some ways. And then it has like a little bit, bit more like an acoustic vibe to it. Like I've just like more guitar randomly, weirdly, whatever. But then definitely some, like there's still some like club bangers on there that, you know, I always gonna have. But yeah, it's just like, it's hard to say, but Glad He's Gone is a good kind of like representation of it. But yeah, it's still, you know, personal and edgy and all that stuff. But yeah, I'm excited to see how you guys feel about it. I'm really proud of it. So I hope you're all into it.
She's still happy, yet still very, very badass. Everyone give Tove Lo a round of applause.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for joining
us.
We're going to actually go outside and take some pictures if that's cool. So we'll let you go finish your tea back there and then we'll come grab you. Bye.